Safety in Alaska is of utmost importance. In a land of extremes, we must take extreme safety precautions. The Fire Medic program in Alaska provides emergency and non-emergency medical care at an incident. When there are 100 people or more on a fire, it is recommended that you order a Fire Medic kit with a medic. The Alaska Smoke Jumpers also have an EMT program and are able to airily deliver EMTs. Check with your local fire contacts in regards to specific protocols for releasing medevacs, remob after medevacs, and priorities for demob. Non-emergency medical transports will be conducted as space is available. Familiarize yourself with Chapter 7 of the Interagency Standards for Fire and Fire Aviation Operations, which is also known as the Red Book. Be sure to communicate clearly with dispatch if a situation is an emergency or non-emergency. Keep heads up for hazardous trees. Most black spruce, white spruce, and hardwoods can have shallow root systems, and when fire weakened, they are likely to blow over with even a slight wind. Especially watch out for falling trees during mop-up operations. Alaska is a land with a long history of military activity. Small arms munitions and unexploded ordnance, or UXO, is out on the landscape primarily on military lands, but also in areas that you may not expect. If you come across any foreign objects that are either intact or in fragments, or any toxic hazards, dump sites and barrels, or anything else suspicious, get a description, take photos, flag it, and report it via dispatch to the Alaska Fire Service Military Zone. They are actively documenting all sightings of munitions and other hazards on and near military lands. Another military-related safety consideration includes the yearly aerial training events that often influence airspace in the vicinity of fires and/or takeoffs and landings at Fort Wainwright. Two of these events are titled Red Flag and Northern Edge. Remember, safety in Alaska, every task, every time.